most of you are familiar with that. It's Hans-Kanzler Weinberger. Weinberger was defining the term of an experimental system, which helps us. Experimental system as a surprise generator, which materializes questions. I don't want to read the slides, I just show them as a short reminder.
The second one takes the skin, and the third one
one statement or one thesis of OPE, the second project. In folio by the noise of the cloud, the skin ego that is determined by Ancier, French psychoanalyst. The skin ego loses its contour, the boundary between the self and the environment is no longer clearly determined. He wrote that in 1985. So these were the two theoretical references we had in this research. The skin ego I already mentioned by Ancier, and the forward by Schmidt-Hurst. The project creates rhizomes and folds between concepts, theories, movements, medias, ecologies, and works, creating and performing media ecologies. If it's about sky performances, it's also asking questions about the here and the there and there, but not understood as a topological difference. Here is not static, but a starting point of a movement. A fold. Bernhard Waldenfels, philosopher, quotes the case of a schizophrenic, who says, I know where I am, but I do not feel to be there. Or, as a fool writes in our book, about to be at two places, remote, present, and at peace inside. That's why I want. And that's what we actually did. We had two performers. So one has been in a bubble, and walking through the urban space. So there was a parkour that we once walked with him in the morning, and then he repeated that in a bubble. And the second person, which in fact is a kind of a schizophrenic setting, because it should be one and the same. He's sitting in a former pub and dealing with the skin disease and reading texts of Monsieur and Deleuze during the 20 minutes or 23 minutes of the performance. And you see why a split screen side up here as a group. Between the things signifies no localizable relationship which connects one part to the other, but the transversal movement continuously changing directions. Now here you see the starting point of the performance. The actor is separating himself from his skin ego in a self-therapeutical movement. An actor performs tests of Monsieur Deleuze in the form of a cover. He interacts via Skype and electric vibrations with a dancer in a plastic bubble, enfolding his skin ego in the streets of the surrounding water. The hyperlocal encounterment of the interacting improvisation, dissonant present experience are evoked by the artist. The performance was subsequently transformed into two other artistic projects, for example, a gallery exhibition in Celestar in France. This is a text by our quote by Didier Monsieur, one of the books, Skin Ego. In brief, the skin ego is an interface between inside and outside, and is the foundation of the container-contained relationship. An important part of psychoanalytic work, the borderline patients in the reconstruction of the early spaces of the skin ego and their consequences for mental organization. Here we see the former. You'll see the parts of the movie afterwards. The forward is the general topology of thought. The inside space is topologically in conflict with the outside space. It brings the two into confrontation at the limit of everything present. Here we see the connection from the point of view of the actor in the former. So, in the inflatable, there have been senses. They delivered rotational data, position of the puppet, and this rotational data was transmitted and transformed into electrical stimuli on the skin of the actor while he was reading, and that was of course kind of a handicap for his way of thinking and expressing and producing the clouds. The dancer in the bubble, he had to repeat the sentence, or that was deliberately complicated to him, by Henry Lesner. As a whole, the organism is only half of its life. You would hear that in the movies that you show on this. So that is stressing the entanglement with the environment. With some perspectives. The fold can begin to reconsider questions of figure ground contextualism and permanent figure ground shifts. Very continuous and reversible dialogue of figure and ground can occur. Michel Serres calls this relation to parasite, folding across lines to create uncertainty between boundaries instead of defined boundaries of separation. These uncertainties create the potential of a multiplicity of folding and unfolding, a re-reading of an architecture of becoming. The fold and the skin are traveling concepts. They stand for multiple layers: the biological layer, foldings of the skin and of living beings; the sociological layer, foldings of society, of communications and politics; the medial layer, foldings of the presenting media of art, the philosophical, and epistemological layer, foldings of concepts, thoughts, and of methods. These entanglements constitute the methods, principles of artistic research and its transdisciplinarity and transmediality. Now, when it comes to these forms, it's very much about that things do not work out as they are supposed to be. And you've got a delay in the connection, you've got interruptions, you've got very difficult and high complex embeddings of the forms in different environments. So that's why noise disturbances create a very important power for these performances. And the philosopher Marcus Rosenberg stresses the aesthetic potential of the disturbance in the sense of making this understanding of media as a figure-ground relationship. The central law of computer science, as you know, does exclude the environmental noise. It's trying to get rid of it. And environment in this model equals noise. And alternative model is the one of the parasite, by Serres. Michel Serres says that things work because they do not work. We are only together because of the parasite. Parasitism becomes, for Serres, a central fact of existence. Without interruption, the system would be locked into an equilibrium state, entirely closed off the rest of the world. The system of Leibniz with closed windows and doors. Serres quote, "What is received is what is sent, plus or minus the parasite. Sometimes the difference is considerable, what arrives sometimes is always almost nothing." I guess becomes the interrupter, the noise becomes interpreter. So I have to skip that a bit, but just have it in the background, so to say. That is another folding of the project, of this performance of the two guys. There was an art gallery which is called the Shopping Window, the Schaufenster, and the viewer is not an author editor, but it's just the first surface of the two windows, and we just heard by the talk of Anne that this slide is in a way ridiculous. But we created the five senses on the ground floor of 43, that is by the verse of the book The Fold. And so in the upper floor is a separated private room in the window, so we would not consider our art project in the second floor, but it would also be the first floor. And stars. Retina, the retina is also a skin. Yeah, so that is a close up of one of the windows, inner pole. German nets out as a fold, as having skin. Fold between the inside and outside. And here we see her sit in front of the window with her smartphone and headphones. To get in touch with the gain perspective on the forms. And now we show you five.
menschliche Denken beruht auf drei Gründe mit der Haut, dem Großen und der sexuellen Vereinigung. Analog zu den drei Varianten der Oberfläche, der Hülle, der Haube, Ausstülpung und der Tasche. Das Ich ist voll mein körperliches. Es ist nicht nur ein Oberflächenwesen, sondern selbst Projektion einer Oberfläche.
Time, and I'm just going to allow
generating a new form of rationality into writing, into defining that. it's interesting because in so there's lectures on IMS, he talks about IMS as in trying to sort of establish the relationality through an internal objective.
Okay.
passion is always